Hello everyone and welcome to the Pencil Tutor channel. I'm Servina and today I will be teaching about impulse and impulsive force. This is Formpop Physics Chapter 2.7. So without further ado, let's get started. Did you guys manage to catch the Olympics recently? Have you ever noticed that when an athlete does a long jump, they will bend their knees right after they did the jump? Well, the purpose of that is to reduce impulsive force. But what exactly is an impulsive force? Impulsive force can be defined as the rate of change of momentum in a collision or impact in a short period of time. And the formula for impulsive force is F equals to mv minus mu divided by time. Now, if we rearrange this formula, we will get something like this. And that would be the formula for impulse. Impulse is another concept that we have to learn. Impulse is defined as the change of momentum. And this would be the formula for impulse. Just like I mentioned before, you can derive the formula for impulse from the formula of impulsive force. Therefore, we must note that both of these, Fd and also mv minus mu, are both the formula for impulse. Therefore, we can conclude that impulse is the product of impulsive force and the impact time. The concept of impulse and impulsive force involves both actions and reactions, which can be explained with Newton's third law of motion. This law states that for every action, there is a reaction of equal magnitude but in the opposite direction. And this is an example for that. You could actually try out an experiment to test this law for yourself. Try sitting on a chair and pushes a wall. You will discover that the wall will actually pushes you back and your chair might even inches back for a bit. Now, let's look at how impulse and impulsive force can be manipulated and applied. Our first application is a little something called follow-through action. Now, follow-through action can be seen when a footballer continues to move its legs together with the ball after kicking it. The purpose of this is to increase the magnitude of impulse. And this is done by increasing the impact time of the ball. And based on the formula of impulse, when the impact time is increased, there will be a larger change in momentum. Therefore, the ball will move at a higher velocity. An important thing you must know about impulsive force is that it is inversely proportional to the impact time. Therefore, to have a larger impulsive force, the impact time must be small. And to have a reduced impulsive force, the impact time must be larger or have a bigger value. Therefore, let's look at reducing impulsive force by extending the impact time. The crumple zone of a car, it expands the impact time during the collision. And this right here would be the crumple zone. Therefore, the magnitude of impulsive force is reduced if the car gets into a collision. There are also action and reactions pair happening on the car, which can be shown in this picture. Next, let's look at increasing impulsive force by reducing impact time. Have you guys ever wondered how a martial artist can break a brick with just their hand? The hand moves at a high velocity and has a short collision time with the brick. Therefore, the magnitude of impulsive force is increased, which will allow the brick to break. There are also action and reaction force happening, with the action coming from the hand and upward reaction coming from the brick, which both plays a part in breaking the brick. Next, let's answer a question together. The diagram shows a test of airbags in a car. What is the function of the airbag? The primary function of the airbag is to increase the impact time of the passenger if there is a car collision happening. Therefore, based on the relationship of impulsive force, since it is inversely proportional with the impact time, the answer would be D. The function of the airbag is to decrease the impulsive force. That is all from me today. Thank you so, so much for watching. I hope you guys learned something today. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment sections down below and I will answer it. Don't forget, we make videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday covering the subjects of physics, mathematics, and biology. That is all from me. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys around.